Dugout Chatter is the most obscure, entertaining, and informative baseball channel yet. Brought to you by Mckay Giffen and Jacob Williams. Welcome to the Dugout.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Dugout Chatter. Posting more frequently because we got some time to make up for.
That's right.
I'm Mckay Giffen.
And I'm Jacob Williams.
All right, guys. I was just going to say before we get into today's video, Jacob has a story that he got to us, our social media coordinator. So, Jacob, what's the hot news off the press today?
Yeah, so today we went and we found out, you know, obviously I'm kind of an Indians fan. So we found out today that Cleveland Indians pitcher Carlos Carrasco, who was put on the injured list for a blood disorder on June 5th, is being treated for leukemia after doctors said that they saw something different in his blood. So, you know, just thoughts and prayers go out to Carlos Carrasco and his family and the entire Indians organization. And that's basically just the news we heard today on July 5th.
Yeah, and it's really heartbreaking, especially coming off of this tragedy with Tyler Skaggs. And, you know, just one quick thing I wanted to say. As a baseball community, yes, we're not Major League Baseball players, but baseball is all our game. It's a fraternity. It's a brotherhood. And we got to stick together and show our love and support for the Angels and the Indians right now because they really need it.
Absolutely. And then now, obviously, you know, getting into the topic of today is the Home Run Derby. The Home Run Derby is going to be later tonight, you know, and the Home Run Derby is going to be hosted by the Indians in Cleveland. So basically what we're going to do is me and Mckay are going to go through our predictions of each series, why we think that that player is going to win, and then go through each series and then go through our champion.
Yeah.
So Mckay, you want to kick it off with going through your first series or matchup.
So how we'll pick it down is we're going to do matchup. Okay, so the first matchup we'll start off with is Christian Yelich versus Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Yep, Yelich the 1 seed, Guerrero Jr. the 8 seed.
And then after that, Jacob will do his and so on and so forth.
All right.
But first up, we have the Major League home run leader, obviously the 1st seed against the lowest seed, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. And my pick to win this round, I'm going with Vladimir Guerrero Jr. I'm going to take that rookie, that young blood, the hot talent. We've seen the power this guy has. And when it comes to the Home Run Derby, home runs in the season don't really matter because it's more of a batting practice competition. And when you look at Christian Yelich, he's got some crazy numbers, obviously, but most of them came from his time wearing a Brewers uniform. His career high with home runs when he was a Marlin was 21 back in 2016, which is pretty impressive in its own, but it's a much bigger ballpark. I think in terms of pure power, Vladimir Guerrero is a better power hitter in terms of strength than Christian Yelich, and he'll have the endurance and a little more like time in between pitches that he'll take advantage of than Yelich. So I think in terms of just raw power and also endurance, I see Vladimir Guerrero Jr. taking this matchup, so I have him beating Christian Yelich.
All right, and then for me in that matchup, I have Christian Yelich. You know, obviously he was the MVP last year. He leads all Major League Baseball players in the first half with 31 home runs. You know, his longest was 462 feet. His career total is 126. And like I said before, he leads the Major Leagues in home runs. He's also the first National League player to have at least 30 home runs before the All-Star break since Albert Pujols in 2009. And he also hits the ball hard. Only exceptions of him is Aaron Judge and Joey Gallo, who own a higher average exit velocity than him. And, you know, for me, I think it should translate well into the Home Run Derby. Progressive field plays well to lefties, and he's the number one player coming in, so I don't think he's going to get bounced in the first round. You know, he's a veteran guy experience. I think he's going to get through Guerrero Jr. So next, what we're going to go through is we're going to go through the second part of the bracket where we have Alex Bregman, the 4 seed, Jock Peterson, the 5 seed. I have Bregman going through. This year, he's got 23 home runs, you know, longest 440 feet. And, you know, for me, I just feel like he has that competitive spirit in him. He wants to win the Derby. He participated in it last year and matched up well with Kyle Schwarber. He only lost to Kyle last year by 1 home run. He had 15 home runs. Kyle had 16, and you know, I feel like he's a bulldog competitor, and I have him getting through, even though, you know, I feel like progressive field plays better to the lefties than Jock Peterson's the lefty. So who do you have coming out of that matchup, Mckay?
So out of that same matchup, I too am picking Alex Bregman, kind of also what you were saying. Last year he was in the Home Run Derby. Last season, to his credit, he finished with 31 home runs. He has 23 in this half so far. And I just think he's like a lot quicker. You know what I mean? Like Jock Peterson's got the big leg kick, the wind. He's just A to B and then hits it through the ball. We already know he's got a ton of power to all fields too. So I think he'll have that edge. And I think he'll get more swings than Jock Peterson. Jock Peterson was in the Home Run Derby, I think in his rookie year, 15. Yeah. But I just give the edge to Bregman more. I just think he's more of a competitor. And I just see him running with it just a lot quicker than Peterson will be.
Yep, and then so we're going to go through the third matchup. Pete Alonso, number 2 seed, and Carlos Santana, the number 7 seed. I have Carlos Santana moving on. I think he could ride the hometown support at least through this first round, you know, to the championship, just like Todd Frazier did in 2015 when he was with Cincinnati, and Bryce Harper did just last year, winning it, and also Justin Bour, you know, everybody forgets about his performance at Marlins Park in 2017.
Judge out-slugged him.
And it's like, Bour got bounced in the first round, but he had the second most home runs in the first round, only to the first one was Judge, who hit 23. And I think that the energy of the fans always seemed to help with a little bit of extra adrenaline. So I have Santana moving past Pete Alonso, Santana the 7th seed, moving on into the second round. Mckay, who do you have?
In that round, I am taking the rookie Pete Alonso. Pete Alonso just on an absolute rampage this year. He's already got 29 home runs. He's hitting 289. We've seen his power all season long. Yeah, Pete Alonso already with 28 home runs on the season, and he's got the most 400-foot homers. So this guy has light tower power. And when you look at his average too, it's really good. And he broke Daryl Strawberry's record for home runs in a single season by a rookie before the All-Star break. And he's hitting 289, so he makes contact consistently, puts the ball in play along with some monster power. Pete Alonso has more of an edge. He'll feel the adrenaline as a rookie. And if you watch him speak on it, this is where he wants to be. And he's already got plans of giving some donations to charity if he's winning. I see him passing against Carlos Santana.
All right, and then now to our fourth and final matchup of the first round. We have Josh Bell and Ronald Acuna. Josh Bell, the 3 seed. Ronald Acuna, the 6 seed. I have Josh Bell winning it. He has 26 home runs this year, and as long as it's 474 feet.
He hit like 2 in the river.
Yeah, have you seen how far he hits the ball? You know, he's had a breakout season. He's had a couple of home runs into the Allegheny River on the right field stands at PNC Park. He just became the 4th player in PNC Park history to reach the river on the fly. Those blasts registered at 472 feet and 454 feet on the StatCast measuring stick. He has hit 3 other home runs, 450 feet plus. Mckay, who do you have?
I'm going to have to copy you on that one, too. Josh Bell, like you were just saying, monstrous power. Look at the adjustments this guy has made this year. He's really just gotten so good at sticking through a baseball and just going up through it. He got challenged by his manager. He's like, hey, you're one of our big guys. You've been in this organization for a couple of years. He challenged him to step it up, and he's done it in the most monster way possible. Josh Bell's hitting over 300, 308 with 27 home runs. He's just behind Pete Alonso and Christian Yelich for the league lead. But when you look at this guy from that competitive spirit, his manager challenged him, and he answered the question by becoming one of the league's best hitters. And so I'm going to match you there, Josh Bell. So, Jacob, who do you have beating who?
In the semifinals, I have Yelich going up against Bregman. And, you know, like I said, aggressive field plays to lefties. But for me, just having Bregman, he's had that experience. He doesn't want to lose again. He has that competitive spirit in him. I think he's going to get by Yelich to reach the finals. And then also my other bracket with Santana and Bell. I like Santana, like I said before. I like how the home crowd's behind him, but I think Josh Bell is just going to be too much enough. So I have Bregman and Bell in my final, the 2 Bs. Who do you have in your final, Mckay?
Now my final, wrapping it back a bit, I have Vladimir Guerrero Jr. against Alex Bregman. And again, I just see Vlad, like, come on, his daddy did it back in 2007. He knows some cheat codes. So I think Vladimir Guerrero Jr., I just see him taking it. You know, he said early on he wants to be there, and he doesn't have the flashiest numbers. He was a recent call-up, but I just think this is where he wants to be, and he'll take it from Bregman. On the other side, I have Josh Bell against Pete Alonso, and like I was saying about Bell earlier, competitor, knows how to just work his craft, continuously getting better. I have him beating out Pete Alonso and him and Vladimir Guerrero Jr. in the final round. So, Jacob, who takes the cake for you?
For me and the Bregman versus Bell, the double B, I think I have to go with Josh Bell. I think he's just going to be too much. I think he hits the ball so hard, and I think a lot of those ones that, you know, for other guys, they don't get out, he has enough power to just get those out. And I think because of that, because of how strong he is, because of how far he can hit the ball, I think he's going to win it. Josh Bell is my 2019 home run champion. How about you, Mckay?
You're wrong. Vlad Jr., who's your daddy?
All right, guys. Well, that concludes the video on home run derby predictions. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and this video. Best way to support the channel, and also make sure you follow us on our Instagram account, dugout.chatter, as well as our Facebook account on Dugout Chatter. Thank you guys for watching this video, and remember,
stay in the dugout.
Stay in the dugout. Have a great one, guys.
What was that decision like as a kid? What kind of made you decide at that early of an age that you'd want to come play baseball in the United States from Bermuda?
So I always had a dream as a little kid back home in Bermuda to play pro ball one day.